गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. सो टुडे वी आर डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज विच विल हेल्प यू टू स्कोर गुड मार्क्स इन योर एग्जामिनेशंस. सो लेट वी स्टार्ट. सो हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस वॉट इज बिजनेस. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस वॉट इज कॉमर्स. सो लेट वी स्टार्ट. It is a branch of business which is concerned with exchange and distribution of goods and services. It includes trade and aids to trade. Commerce kya hai? It is a branch of business which is concerned with exchange and distribution of goods and services. Which is related to exchange and distribution of goods and services. Now it includes trade and aids to trade. So we will say that ki इसमें ट्रेड भी होता है एंड एड्स टू ट्रेड. व्हाट इज ट्रेड एंड व्हाट इज एड्स टू ट्रेड? सो ट्रेड रेफर्स टू सेल, ट्रांसफर एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज, वेयर द एड्स टू ट्रेड इज रेफर्स टू द सर्विसेज दैट विल हेल्प यू टू द स्मूथ फंक्शनिंग ऑफ योर बिजनेस. दैट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन? सो ट्रेड रेफर्स टू द सेल, एक्सचेंज एंड ट्रांसफर ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज, वेयर एड्स टू ट्रेड हेल्पर्स फॉर स्मूथ फंक्शनिंग. And where trade helpers to sale, exchange or transfer of goods and services. I hope that is clear to everyone. Now the trade is further divided into two parts. That first one is internal trade and the second one is external trade. So what is internal trade and what is external trade? Internal trade refers to buying and selling of goods and services within the geographical boundaries. Internal trade refers to buying goods and services within the geographical boundaries. It means it is also known as home trade. Internal trade is also known as home trade. So now further, internal trade is divided into two parts, that is wholesale trade and retail trade. So what is wholesale trade and what is retail trade? Wholesale trade refers to buying goods and services in a large quantity. It means in wholesale trade we have to buy goods and services in a large quantity, where if we are talking about retail trade, it refers to buying goods and services in a small quantity. It means in wholesale trade we have to buy goods and services in a large quantity, where in retail trade we will buy goods and services in a small quantity. That is clear. In wholesale trade we will directly buy goods from the manufacturer, but in retail trade we will buy goods from the wholesaler. I hope that is clear to you. In wholesale trade we will directly buy the goods from the manufacturer, and in retail trade we will directly buy goods from the wholesaler. Now in wholesale trade we will buy goods in a bulk, where in retail trade we will buy goods in a small quantity. Another point that is important while including wholesale trade and retail trade is that in wholesale trade they will deal with single line product, where the retail trade deals with variety of products. I hope that is clear to everyone. Okay, now we will discuss what is external trade. As we learn that internal trade is refers to buying and selling of goods and services within the geographical boundaries, in external trade buying and selling of goods and services outside the geographical boundaries. It means we will also known as, it is also known as foreign trade. That is clear to you. Okay, foreign trade, or we can say internal trade as a domestic trade also. Home trade, domestic trade, External trade is further divided into three parts, that is export, import and interport. What is export, what is import and what is interport? Now we will discuss. Export refers to the sale of goods to the foreign countries. It means we will sell something to the foreign countries, that is known as export. If we buying something from the foreign countries, it is known as import. For example, if we are talking about export, export means if we sell something to the China, Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, that is known as export. If we sell something, okay? If we buying something from these countries, just like China, Pakistan, Nepal, that is known as import. Now the question arises, sir, export is clear, keep buying, selling goods from foreign countries and buying goods from foreign countries is known as import. Sir, what is interport? So it refers to import of goods for the purpose of export. It means it refers to import goods for the purpose of export. Sir, what does it mean? It means import goods. If we import goods from any country, suppose if we import goods from China, okay, that is clear. If we buying goods from China, for not for the consumption, we will sell these goods to the another country, just like USA, China. Sorry, not China. We will suppose if we buy goods from the China and we will sell these goods to Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, that is known as interport. We will buy goods not for our consumption, for selling purpose, that is known as interport. Okay, I hope that is clear to you. It means import goods for the purpose of export. We will import goods from some countries and sell goods from another country. That is clear to you. Okay, now we will take a quick revision. What we have studied, we have studied that commerce, it is a branch of business which is concerned with the exchange and distribution of goods and services. It includes trade and aids to trade. That is clear. Now further we divided classification of commerce into two parts, that is trade and aids to trade. Trade refers to sale, exchange and transfer of goods and services, where aids to trade refers to the smooth functionings of these goods and services. Now further we divided trade into two parts, that is known as internal trade and external trade. Internal trade is also known as domestic trade and home trade, where external trade is also known as foreign trade. Now internal trade is divided into two parts, that is wholesale trade and retail trade. In wholesale trade, we will buy goods in a bulk and sell to the retailers. And in retail trade, we will sell directly contact with the customer. Okay. Now, what is external trade? External trade is further divided into three parts, that is export, import and interport. Export refers to sales of goods and services to the foreign countries. Import refers to buying goods and services from the foreign countries. Interport refers to import goods for the purpose of export. We will buy goods for the purpose of export, not for our consumption. I hope that is clear to you. Now we will talk about what is aids to trade. As we know that it will help us for smooth functioning. It will help us for the smooth functioning of the business. So what does that include? It includes transportation. Transportation, it refers to transfer goods from one place to another. Because in business, we do not consume the same thing at the same place. We will send them for the another parts of the country for their consumption. Okay, I hope that is clear to you. Now we will discuss what is banking and finance. It provides credits for smooth functioning of the business. It provides credits for the smooth functioning of business. now what is insurance? It is also a part of aids to trade. It protects goods from various damages or wear and tears that will happen while transferring from goods one place to another. It should be maybe for fire insurance, water insurance, or any kind of damages that will happen while transporting goods from one place to another. It will protect from various risks. I hope that is clear. Now, what is warehouses? Warehouses. Now we will discuss what is warehouses. To store goods which are not consumed immediately. Warehouses is a place where we have to store our goods because there is a time या फिर gap between production and the consumption of the goods. So warehouses help us to store the goods and for the safe purpose or which are not consumed immediately. Now, if we are talking about advertising, to increase its reach, advertising help us to increase its reach. It means it will, we know that ki every place of India or any country, we will inform about the products and with the help of advertisement. And to inform the quality of goods, uses of goods and prices of our goods. With the help of advertisement, we will also inform about the quality of the goods, uses of that goods and prices of that goods. For example, suppose I am selling a marker. So what are the prices of that marker? What are the uses of that marker? What are the which quality I have provided them for the uses? I hope that is clear to you. That's aids to trade. It's include five things, that is transportation for transfer goods from one place to another, banking and finance, providing credit for the smooth functioning of the business, insurance protect goods from various risks, warehouses to store goods which are not consumed immediately, advertising to increase its reach and to inform the quality, use and prices of that goods. I hope ye cheez, everything is clear to you. Take a screenshot of it if you want, or note it down in your copy. I will back in 2 minutes. I hope ki aap log sabhi logon ne screenshot le liya hoga. Now we will discuss what is business risk. Now it refers to the probability of losses due to unforeseen circumstances and events. As we know that we are, while doing a business, there is some chances of risk because risk is everywhere, hai na? So it business risk refers to, it refers to the probability of losses due to unforeseen circumstances and events. Sometimes there is unforeseen circumstances, there is a chances of losses in a business or any event that we have organized, okay? That is known as business risk. What are the nature of business risk? There are 4 points that we have discussed. What are business risk and its nature? Risk, business risk arise due to uncertainty. It is arise by the uncertainty. Maybe there is a change in technology, there is a earthquake. So there is business risk arise due to uncertainty. Uncertainty is maybe of many kind. Now it should be the natural or man-made. Risk is essential part of every business. If you are doing a business, there is a chances of risk. Either they get sufficient profit or they get in the loss also. So it is a part of every business. Degree of risk depends upon the nature and the size of a business. Degree of risk, it means what kind of risk that you have bear. It depends upon the nature, what kind of business you are doing, and size of the business. It is a big or a small business. The fourth point is, that is profit is a reward for bearing a risk. Everyone doing a business for the purpose of earning profit, but for that profit is a reward for bearing a risk. If a person is bearing a risk, so profit will be given for that person for bearing that risk in a business. I hope that is clear to you. So there are 4 points. Business risks arise due to uncertainty. Risk is essential part of every business. Degree of risk depend upon the nature and the size of the business. And profit is a reward for bearing a risk to the business. Okay, we will add it to the business view. Okay, now we will discuss what are the causes of business risk. There are 4 types of causes that we have faces in the business risk. That is natural causes, human causes, economical causes, and physical causes. Now, what is natural causes? Natural causes are just like earthquake, flood, drought, etc. Suppose you are doing a business and the earthquake arise, your business should be end up, है ना? या फिर flood आ गया वहाँ पर, it depends upon them, ठीक है? Now we will talk about what are human causes. Human causes just like the person working in your organization making frauds, ठीक है? Now or the management, the employees that is working in the organization is making fraud to the management. Now leaking secrets of business, the employees leak the secrets of the business. Just like we have seen that Coca-Cola does not leak its secret of making Coca-Cola. So if any employees of that Coca-Cola company will leak their secret, that they suffer losses. Now what is carelessness? Human causes is also include carelessness. The people does not, the employees does not work in a proper way. It is also a cause of human causes in a business risk. Now we will discuss what is economic causes. Market fluctuation, there is change in the market, ups and down. We will know that there is ups and down in the market. So market fluctuation, change in fashion. Suppose you are buying goods that are now in trend, but after 1 or 2 months the fashion will be completely changed. So it is also economic loss. Taste and TNP, that is known as taste and preferences, the taste and preferences of the customer. Suppose everyone does not like a same white shirt, somewhere some people like yellow, black, green, hai na? So not everyone like black pant and white shirt. Okay, now we will discuss what are physical causes. Physical causes is like outdated machinery in a organization or a business or a firm. We are using outdated machinery, it is a physical cause. Old technology, we are using old technology and the production level will goes down. There should be a mechanical defect. It is also a part of physical causes that will affect our business. Okay, so these are the 4 kinds that we have discussed, that are natural causes, human causes, economical losses, and physical causes. I hope these 4 points are clear to you and businesses is clear to you. Thank you everyone. Please like, share, and subscribe the channel and take a screenshot of that. That will help you to remind the things in a better way.